Capitec released its half-year financials for the 6 months ended August 2024. The company reported operating profit at 8.3 billion rand. That's up 41% on the year prior. It also reported headline earnings per share coming in at 5,544 cents, up 36%. Capitec now boasts 23 million clients, a substantial increase on the 12.9 million clients it had on its books in 2019. Shareholders are set to get a gross interim ordinary dividend of 20.85 rand, up 36% on the same time last year. Well, to take us behind the numbers, I'm joined by Harry Fourie. He's the CEO of Capitec. Thank you very much, Harry, for joining us. So your numbers are looking quite impressive for your first half. What were the key drivers behind this performance?
Yeah, you can't pinpoint anything specific. I think, you know, if I look at credit growth was muted, particularly due to the economy. But a very strong performance on our impairments. We've improved that with 1 billion. And then very strong performance in our transactional income and our VAS products, which contributed another 2 million. And then our insurance business grown with 14%. So it's more a combination of all our different initiatives that we are busy with that has contributed to the growth.
Yeah. So when it comes to your business banking segment, just remind us of when you started it and the kind of growth you've seen and what your offering is in terms of distinguishing yourself. What has your value proposition been for businesses to bank with you?
Yeah, I think if you look at business banking, we bought Mercantile in December 2019. Unfortunately, you then had COVID. So for 2 years, we were actually fighting COVID. But I think what we've done in the last couple of years is build a completely new digital relationship offer, whereby you've got a bank in your pocket 24 hours available. We've rebranded from the 1st of March. In that rebranding, we've changed our transactional fee to exactly the same as retail, 1 rand per transaction. That is unheard of in South Africa, because normally your business bank clients pays much more. And now we've started with the whole merchant services side, that where we've reduced our point of sale machines, we've reduced our pricing on commission rates, make it very transparent. And like I said, we actually, the foundations are there now. It's how do we actually really start growing business banking from now onwards. So we're very excited about the business banking offer.
So last year, you recorded your credit impairment levels at the highest you'd seen. And I see that you've managed to whittle down those by over 1 billion rand. What's been the strategy in this regard? And have you become quite much more risk averse?
Yeah, I think I've said it in the past. You know, we opened up in end of 2022. We didn't expect Russia-Ukraine to happen. And then we had to react. We tightened our credit criteria. We were about 28% tighter or more conservative than the market. The result of that is that our credit loss ratios on the personal banking side has dropped from 11% to 8.3%, in line with our target, because our through the cycle target is 8.5%. So we're very happy with it. And then if I look at the economy, things has changed, inflation coming down, interest rates coming down, no load shedding, we've started to open up. So from about July onwards, we've opened up on the credit space, and we believe there's potential in that space.
So it was very interesting to learn that you guys hired around 700 people in the period under review, with most of them being in the IT discipline. How much and where have you been investing when it comes to technology, and how is this hopefully going to translate in your operations and your bottom line?
Well, if you look at the last 5 years, we've invested close to 7 billion rand in IT and technology and data. A big portion of that is staff. If you really think about what a bank is, it's all about technology, it's all about data, it's all making certain you understand your client, and that's where we're investing, and we continue investing. If you look at our core systems, we've moved all our data to the cloud. We're using best-of-class Salesforce, Encino, Microsoft, SAP, and that has enabled us to create that platform whereby our IT people can really focus on producing product and services to our clients. And I think that's what you're seeing in the growth in our earnings, is the fact that our product offering has increased quite a lot.
So, of course, you've got quite a physical presence around the country, but of course you're investing heavily in the digital space, which is the future. 10 years hence, 20 years hence, are there going to be branches still available in South Africa? Because how do you balance the need, you know, to have digital systems for people to transact efficiently while at the same time still having a human touch in the delivery of service?
Well, it's interesting. 3 years ago, we had the similar question. We had 850 branches. We're still at 860 branches. We're actually opening up another 10, 15 branches this year. Branches is for us critical. What you find is we've moved all the transactional side away into digital. But that human touch, the ability to explain a product, to sit down and understand what a product is all about, the features, benefit, it's only a human that can really do that. So we believe our branches is very crucial in our success of selling our product range into our client base. So I can't see that a change. I believe if you really want to be successful, you need to have a strong branch presence and you need a very strong digital presence.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Harry, for your time and your insights there. That was Harry Faure. He's the CEO of Capitec.